What's going to happen to the unbelieving nations at the time of the final, fiery, universal judgment of God? That's what the book of Zephaniah is all about. The day of God's wrath, the day of the Lord, the final judgment. What Zephaniah is going to tell us, what happens to the unbelieving nations when they pass through that fire, is not what the Western Church has told us. You better strap in as we dive in. Zephaniah 1:7 in the New King James Version. Listen to this. Be silent in the presence of the Lord God, for the day of the Lord is at hand. For the Lord has prepared a sacrifice. He has invited his guests. The day of the Lord is a day of sacrifice, and he's invited the guests. Sounds like doom and gloom to me, until we find out that the purpose of the sacrifice is to cleanse the nations from their own unbelief. Zephaniah 1:18 in the NIV. The theme is unpacked. Neither their silver nor their gold, the nations, will be able to save them on the day of the Lord's wrath. In the fire of his jealousy, the whole earth will be consumed. For he will make a sudden end of all who live on the earth. Santa, this is talking about doom and gloom for all the nations. They're not going to be able to buy their way out of this. The fire of his jealousy is going to consume the whole earth and bring a sudden end to all who live on the earth. How can this be cleansing? Wait and see. See the phrase there? In the fire of his jealousy, the whole earth will be consumed. He doesn't tell us what that phrase means there, but he will in chapter 3, 8 and 9. We'll get there. Just park that phrase in your mind. In the fire of his jealousy, the whole earth will be consumed. Are you ready? Zephaniah 2:11, he's unpacking the wrath of God, the final judgment, even more. And now we have a twist. We know one thing for sure, the day of his wrath, the day of judgment, is the fire of his jealousy that consumes the whole earth. What gets consumed? Look, Zephaniah 2:11 in the NIV. The Lord will be awesome to them, to the nations, when he destroys all the gods of the earth. Wow. So now the final judgment is including the destruction of the gods of the nations. Now the story is starting to change. We read in 1:18 that this final judgment is the fire of his jealousy. And now we read that God's going to be awesome to the nations when he shows the fire of his jealousy, when he destroys all the gods of the earth. They're the ones who come in for destruction. Watch how he unpacks this. The Lord will be awesome to them, to the nations, when he destroys all the gods of the earth, and then distant nations will bow down to him, all of them, in their own lands. Wow! On the day of God's final judgment, when the fire of his jealousy burns, the whole of earth will be consumed, and he will be awesome to them, to the nations, when he destroys their gods. And as a result of this fiery judgment, where he releases his jealousy, the distant nations will end up bowing down to him, all of them, in their own lands. The final judgment of unbelievers focuses on the destruction of their gods, so that they will end up bowing down to him in their own lands. You see, now we know what it means. In the fire of his jealousy, the whole earth will be consumed. He's jealous. He's jealous, and it burns like fire. What's he jealous of? The Lord will be awesome to them when he destroys all the gods of the earth. He's jealous. The other nations have got other gods. No, they will bow down to me. I will destroy their gods. I'm a jealous God. It burns like fire, a hunk of burning love. That's what he's got. So, Santo, when it says there, the distant nations will bow down to him and all in their own lands, that could just mean that they're confessing that Jesus is Lord and then he's going to kill them. No. All this is unpacked in chapter 3. And we're there now. Yeah. When God's fire of his wrath on the final judgment is poured out, he's going to be awesome to the nations. He's going to burn their gods because he's jealous. You belong to me. Genesis 12:3, he said to Abraham, Abraham, I'm going to bless you and all the nations of the earth. They belong to me. They don't belong to the other gods. I'm going to consume the whole earth, the gods. And then they're going to bow down to me. Well, if they've been consumed by the fire and they're gone, how can they be alive to bow down? Hey, right? This will be brought up now in chapter 3 and it'll become crystal clear. He brings the first three chapters together and he tells us what happens to the unbelieving nations at the time of the final fiery universal judgment. Listen, remember he's jealous. Zephaniah 3, 8 and 9 in the New King James Version. Here's verse 8. Therefore wait for me, says the Lord, until the day, of the Lord, judgment day, until that day I rise up for plunder. You plunder the possessions of your enemy. To plunder means to steal the goods of your enemy. And he's just said in chapter 2 that the nations are worshipping other gods and that he's jealous and it burns like fire, a hunk of burning love. And he said, you wait, what I do for the nations, it'll be awesome. I will destroy their gods and they will bow down to me in their own lands. They're still alive when the fire has come out. And now he says, wait for the day that I rise up for plunder. I'm going to steal you from the gods. I'm a jealous God. Therefore, wait for me, says the Lord, until the day I rise up for plunder. My determination is to gather the nations. What's he going to plunder? He's going to gather the nations. That's what he's plundering. He's plundering that which he is gathering from the enemy, the gods. Therefore, wait for me, says the Lord, until the day I rise up for plunder, for my determination is to gather the nations. He's plundering the nations. He's ripping them off from the other gods. He's jealous. You belong to me. My determination is to gather the nations to my assembly of kingdoms. My assembly of kingdoms. They belong to him. My assembly of kingdoms. I'm going to plunder. I'm going to rip them off. I'm going to gather the nations and they become my assembly of kingdoms. And I will pour on them my indignation. Watch. Sounds like he's going to wipe them out. No, it doesn't. To pour on them my indignation, all my fierce anger. Hold on. What's it going to do to them? Wipe them out? No. We've already got a hint in 2:11 that when he pours out his fire and his anger, that they're going to bow to him. Well, if they've been wiped out, are they bowing to him? Yeah? Here it comes. To my assembly of kingdoms, to pour on them my indignation. What does that mean? All my fierce anger. What does that mean? All the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy. Same phrase as the last chapter. And when we read that phrase in the last chapter, what did the nations end up doing? Their gods got destroyed and they ended up bowing down to God in their nations. They were left alive and they're going to be left alive here. Look at the end of verse 8 and the beginning of verse 9. It's clear. All my fierce anger, all the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy. I'm going to plunder you from the other gods. All the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy, for then I will restore to the peoples a pure language. Now hang on a minute. If they've been devoured and burned up, how come they're restored? You can't have this both ways. Fire purifies. The fire of God's jealousy restores the peoples. It burns away their loyalty to the other gods. God's jealous. You are mine. You are mine. With the fire of my jealousy, for then, when he burns them, devoured. What's devoured? Not them. They're still alive. They're still alive. All the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy, for then I will restore to the peoples. The fire restores. His jealous fire restores to the people a pure language. Why? Why their language? They had been worshipping the other gods, and as not, you're not going to call on them anymore. The fire is going to burn your unbelief from your lips. He says so. Look, for then I will restore to the peoples a pure language that they all will call on the name of the Lord to serve him with one accord. The fire burns their way, their unbelief. They will then call on him. They will call on the name of the Lord, not the name of the other gods. He's a fiery God. He's a passionate God. He's a jealous God. And he says, I'm going to burn all this away. I'm going to get rid of your gods. And then I'll restore to you the peoples a pure language so that you call on the name of the Lord and you serve him with one accord, not your other gods. You belong to me. What happens to the unbelieving nations at the time of the final fiery judgment? God destroys their gods. He burns away their unbelief. He cleanses their, he restores their lips so that they will call on the name of the Lord, Jehovah, Yahweh, to worship him in one accord. What happens to the unbelieving nations at the time of the final fiery judgment? God burns away their unbelief, and they're left very much alive, calling on the name of the Lord and worshipping him alone. That's the future of the unbelieving nations. God bless you.